We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Detective Comics number 996. We are quickly reaching the 1000 mark. This issue continues the mythology storyline, written by Peter Tomasi, pencils by Doug Mahnke, inker was Jaime Mendoza and Mark Irwin, colorist David Barron, letter Rob Leigh, cover by Mahnke, Mendoza, and Barron, which is a pretty good cover, I like it. It's dynamic and it says a lot about what's going to happen in the issue. The assistant editor was Dave Walgos, editor Chris Conroy, group editor Jamie Rich. Okay, so there's something going on between Batman and Damian that they don't really explain, and I don't really care about. Apparently it's something to do with this trade paperback story, whatever. Anyway, Batman has come up with a possible suspect in Henry Ducard, and he is a man who taught Batman to hunt people, so he knows Batman's identity, and it has to be somebody that knows that Batman and Bruce Wayne are the same person. So he travels to Paris and starts going undercover in various disguises to get information out of people as to where Ducard might be. And he ends up finding him in the catacombs. And of course, a fight ensues, but there is a mutual enemy afoot. Batman is led further on his quest to find out who is trying to hunt the people that trained him. And there's some really cool panels in here. The art is really good, actually, in this issue. I'm really starting to like the style a lot more, so I really like the art. The story is fantastic. It really is kind of whodunit, and it's leading up to, I think, the 1000th issue, but they left us with a cliffhanger for next issue, which is the important part. As a standalone issue, it's okay. Doesn't really give you enough information to work with, I don't think, but definitely a solid issue and a solid installment in the storyline. So with that being said, I'm going to recommend this. I thought it was a fun issue. Like I said, the interior art is actually a little better than the cover. And there's some really cool sequences in here, some good interactions. And it's very plot driven, which I liked a lot. But overall, just a really interesting storyline that is worth checking out. So if you get a chance to pick this up, I would recommend it. I would say it's probably worth the cover price, which I don't think they're worth $4. But you could easily get by with paying $2 or $3 for this and not feeling bad if you're going to read the whole story arc. As a standalone, it's not really going to be worth that much to you. But that's just my take on it. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. And we hope to see you on the next one.